Welcome to the inaugural Rock Springs Mayor's Arts Awards. I'm Mayor Tim Como, and I'm very excited to host this virtual event. In November of 2019, Rock Springs was named one of three pilot communities for the Wyoming Arts Alliance Professional Development Program. The Rock Springs Main Street Urban Renewal Agency, URA, and the Community Fine Arts Center jointly applied for the program. Since then, Rock Springs art organizations, businesses, and individuals, along with WIA, program coordinator, have been collaborating on a regular basis on all aspects of developing this unique pilot workshop. From these meetings, the Sweetwater Arts Partnership Group was formed. One of the projects that was discussed at these workshops was to have the mayor of Rock Springs recognize local artists, patrons of arts, arts educators, and community art supporters at a Mayor's Arts Awards banquet. There are so many benefits in highlighting the arts in a community. Strong partnerships within the arts stimulate economic growth, promote the city's revitalization, encourage tourism, and enhance Rock Springs' cultural image. The arts give life to our city. Nominees for the Mayor's Arts Award had to be Sweetwater County citizens, organization, or business that exemplified a long-term commitment to the arts in Rock Springs. I'm proud to announce that we received several qualified nominations for this award. So without further ado, let's award the winners. We have four awards to present tonight from the categories Performing Artist, Arts Educator, Patron of the Arts, and Arts Organization. Our first award winner is Steve Davis, who is not only talented, but generous with his music. Steve was nominated by Chad Banks and the Main Street URA Board. Here to tell us more is Sue Lozier, the URA Board Secretary.
Stephen Davis has been musical all of his life and performing for the last 18 years. He writes many of his own songs, and you can see him performing all around Sweetwater County, including downtown Rock Springs. Music has been a constant passion of Stephen's, and every song Stephen has written has a story, an original background, and has been written through his life experiences. Stephen is one of the nicest people you will ever meet. Congratulations, Stephen.
Same old road in my hometown, with the same friends still around. I wait for the whispers of the road to call me on my way. Where my friends do always stay, yes for me, yes for me. That road keeps calling me, I'm on my way. Through horizons, time and space, yeah. I don't mind, no. Where I lay my head is my home. Wasting time never meant that much. I am home, I am home, I am home. Where I lay my head.
I'm very honored to be one of the recipients of the Mayor's Art Award. I was very humbled to have been chosen to receive this award, as there are so many talented artists in our community worthy of praise. I would like to start by thanking Chad Banks for nominating me, and also for breathing fresh life into our community through art and music. Events like the Brown Bag Lunches, the Farmers Markets, and the Downtown Art Strolls are just a few of the things that are truly making art shine brightly again, and I couldn't be happier. I would also like to give special thanks to local businesses and their owners in town that have made it a point to keep art alive. Places like Eve's Restaurant, the Pickin' Palace, Johnny Mac's, Sidekick's Book Bar, Square State Brewery, and Fiesta Guadalajara are just some of the local businesses that make sure an artist like me can always play, and art can always be hung on their walls. It's the thing that makes Rock Springs such a cool place to live in. Of course, I couldn't do it without the support of my family, my wife and kids, my mom and siblings, and my friends. Thank you again for this award, and I look forward to sharing music and good times with you all in the future.
Yeah. In the next category, arts educator, I've selected Sherry Coomer for her commitment to her students and the community. Local glass artist and arts supporter who is active in the arts community, Susie Von Ahrens nominated Sherry Coomer.
I would like to congratulate Sherry Coomer on receiving the 2021 Mayor's Arts Award in the category of arts educator. She truly deserves this honor. Along with Sherry's dedication to her students and to the arts in the community, she has also been recognized with several awards throughout her career. In 2016, she was recognized as Sweetwater County School District No. 1 Teacher of the Year. In 2017, Sherry was selected as the Wyoming Secondary Art Educator of the Year and then went on to receive the Wyoming Art Educator Award from the National Art Education Association later that year. Sherry is very passionate about her work and her art. Through her knowledge, the projects that came out of her classes are meaningful and inspiring. One of her former students quoted, "Sherry Coomer has been one of my most influential art teachers. She greatly inspired me at a young age to create art while instilling a passion for art. I hope to one day achieve the creativity and craftsmanship she exemplified. Her optimistic attitude truly made art a fun experience. Sherry, thank you for all you do. I am very honored to present to you the 2021 Rock Springs Mayor's Arts Award."
I want to thank Susie Von Ahrens for nominating me for this award. I was pleasantly surprised to be recognized for my work as an artist and art educator. Art is a huge part of my life, and I am so happy that the Downtown URA and Community Finance Center have partnered to promote art in our community. Thank you, Chad Banks and Deborah Soule, for your combined efforts. Deborah deserves an extra big thank you from me, because if it weren't for her and the Fine Arts Center, I wouldn't have been brave enough to even put my artwork out there for public viewing. The teacher art show that follows Youth Arts Month every other year has given me a space for exhibiting work alongside the other talented art teachers from Sweetwater County School District No. 1. I hope our school district understands the gems we have in our art department right now. I'd like to give a special shout out to Hallie Riscus, the only current art teacher that has been with the district longer than I have, and the one that helped me the most when I started teaching. Besides being a great teacher and wonderful artist, she also happens to be one of the kindest human beings I know. I consider myself extraordinarily lucky to have a support squad, my family and friends, who encourage me in my creative pursuits. Thanks, Mom and Dad, Tom, Katie, Steve, Tracy, Shelley, Tammy, Deb, Josh and Eve, Denise, everyone. Lastly, I want to thank my students, past, present, and future, for keeping my job interesting. When you work with high school students, no 2 days are ever the same. High school kids are challenging, entertaining, quirky characters that keep me on my toes. I only want the best for them, and I hope they find joy in the creative process. I want them to know that art is worth doing, whether you're good at it or just having fun. I can't help but feel a sense of pride when I find out a former student still enjoys drawing, painting, making pottery or jewelry, anything. Some are creating for fun, others are selling their art. Several have their own tattoo businesses, one has their own home decoration business, one is making a living selling his pottery, and I'm sure there are others out there that I just don't even know about. I'm just so happy to be a part of our art community. Thank you once again, and thank you to everyone that supports the arts.
Our next award goes to someone in our community who demonstrates a love for our town and is an active patron of the arts, Bernadine Kraft. She was nominated by Chad Banks and the Main Street URA Board. Here's URA Board Chair Maria Mortensen.
Dr. Bernadine Kraft has been involved in the arts in Rock Springs for more years than her nominator, Chad Banks, can remember. Bernadine has been a longtime volunteer and board member with the Sweetwater County Concert Association, providing arts year-round to our local area. Her passion for providing arts to the community is unmatched. In her role with Sweetwater BOCES, Bernadine, along with the board, regularly fund arts programming, bringing in unique authors and performers. In addition, they provide funding for the arts to the school district, both expanding the scope of the arts to the children and members of the community who typically don't attend traditional concerts. Bernadine is an avid art supporter from a personal standpoint as well, both attending and providing financial support. She was a founding member of the Rock Springs Box Art Committee, which is wrapping highly visible power boxes around Rock Springs with artistic pieces. If all of that isn't enough, you've likely seen her perform at one of the Actors Mission productions. She also serves as a member of their executive producers to help raise funds for their new space. The Actors' Mission brings local theater productions to life, giving both performers and the audience a chance to further engage with the arts. There aren't many art programs in Sweetwater County that you won't find Bernadine involved with, whether front and center or behind the scenes. She is a true gift to Rock Springs and Sweetwater County, who has brightened our community through her love of the arts and her commitment to making them ever present for all. Congratulations, Bernadine.
This is such a great honor for me to be chosen because few things matter more to me than support of the arts. They've been a part of my life really since before I could even remember, from my earliest days when I tried to turn our living room into a sound studio or a dance studio, all the way up to receiving degrees in theater and speech communications in college. And I knew I'd never attempt to work professionally in either of those areas. But those degrees, emphasizing the importance of human communication, could not have been more valuable to me in my educational, psychology, and even legislative careers. And one of the pieces of legislation I was especially proud of in my 10 years in the state legislature was actually one of my very earliest. And it was an amendment that added a fine and performing arts requirement to the Hathaway Success curriculum. And when I was fighting for that amendment, I collected mountains of information on the importance of the fine and performing arts in human development. I discovered that studying any of the arts expands and improves all learning. And I'm not going to get into all that technical research, but it was further proof of something I'd instinctively known since infancy. The arts, quite simply, enrich, enhance, and expand our lives. I've been privileged throughout my life to have received so many opportunities to support the arts, not just at the legislative level, but also bringing live professional entertainment to Sweetwater County through the Concert Association, providing educational opportunities through our Sweetwater BOCES Artist in Residence and Music in the Schools programs, to providing arts enrichment classes and scholarship opportunities in the arts, and sponsoring any number of local arts programs and artists. But of all that, one experience that perhaps more than any other defined my commitment to the arts took place actually in Bethlehem, that little town that's now a walled city, and it's often called a beautiful open-air prison. We visited an artist co-op where we bought Christmas ornaments made from glass shards of bombed-out windows and nativity sets made from the wool of Palestinian sheep. And creating such beauty from so much destruction and despair, the artists talked of the importance of their work, telling us that amidst the brokenness, their art spoke when words could not, reminding of our shared humanity, of who we are and who we are called to be. They express something I have believed all my life. Without art, we wouldn't be human. Thank you.
Last but not least is the arts organization category. I'm honored to recognize the Actors' Mission. This group has many members who are committed to this organization. Dave Gutierrez and Gwendolyn Quitberg are the nominators, and to receive the award is Brad Russell, founding member of the Actors' Mission Board of Directors.
19 years, 19 seasons, 68 plays. That's quite an accomplishment for a homegrown theater set up by well-intentioned amateurs. In 2003, Actors' Mission had its debut performance on a makeshift stage in a rundown storefront on Pilot Butte. What was to come wasn't on my mind when I walked into that theater to talk about a part in the theater's third play. Like many others to follow, I was there seeking a creative outlet. What I found, and what I didn't count on, was finding a home. When folks think of the theater, they tend to think of what they see on stage. But for every actor on stage, there's an army in support off stage. Each volunteer learns to play many roles. There's a role, probably more than one, for all. That role extends to the kitchen. In line with our motto, feed the body, nourish the mind, we provide a free meal as a gift to our audience before every performance. That's a very popular tradition. We have never charged admission. It's right there in our charter. By the way, all auditions are guaranteed, open to all. As for the nourish the mind part, well, our gift to the community has been our carefully chosen plays. From the beginning, we have put on shows that delight and entertain. But we are also committed to plays that provoke and educate, that rattle preconceptions, and that make our audiences think. We are also determined to give voice to homegrown writers, composers, musicians, and other local artists of every stripe.
Like many people, I came into the Actors Mission as an audience member. Audience members are very important because without the audience, the actors have nothing to play for. No applause, no adulation. They need an audience to power them. They put on 4 shows a year, and it's just the best way to watch live theater in Rock Springs. I remember sitting in that tiny little space in the Elks Club and watching and feeling the magic. It's not just the actors that bring a play to life, although it takes an extraordinarily brave person to check their ego at the door and become someone else. And what if that someone else is a villain? I could never do that. And I so admire the people who can. All those lines to learn and make the audience believe that you're not the friend they came to the theater with, but this whole new character. It boggles the mind. But what really got me hooked was in the details, the background, the set changes, the costumes, disguising the people you thought you knew. This grand tradition known as theater, the mother of all the arts. The artists behind the scenes who create the illusion that you're not sitting in a dark room on a somewhat uncomfortable chair, but you're somewhere else in some other time. That's the magic of the stage. And now we have a new building to create this magic in. Our main stage and electric guy talked his family into donating a wonderful old building in downtown Rock Springs to the Actors Mission to convert into a permanent theater. We're currently remodeling 440 South Main into a black box theater with comfy seats and dressing rooms and prop storage and carpenter shops and a kitchen and all the things that all the people need to make the magic that is on stage. Thank you, Rock Springs. Come see us.
Thank you so much. What an honor. I'd like to thank the mayor and the selection committee for choosing to honor us in this first Mayor's Arts Award. We're truly humbled. There's so many people involved in the Actors Mission, but I would like to try and thank a few. Our executive producers, especially, who keep the faith alive and fundraise nonstop for us, Margaret Russell, Jan Torres, Barbara Smith, Norma Previdel, Janice Jordan, Paula Wanacott, Sandy DeRiff, Vicki Roth, Kathy Gilbert, Vi Gessner, Pat Swan-Smith, and of course, Dr. Bernadine Kraft, our tireless board of directors, Rick Kozad, Angela Thatcher, myself, Shane Westfall, Kenneth McCormick, and Charlotte Doak, in addition to our Actors Mission family, who have given so much of their time over the years, like David Gutierrez, Roy Hansen, Jeff Varley, Nina Tyler, Eric Hamm, Jasmine Weaver, Christina Magagna, Aaron Vollner, and so many others. This has been a difficult year for live arts. It's been hard on everyone, of course, but when what you do is focused on bringing people together for shared experiences and social interaction, and the entire country is recommending to stay isolated and separate, our job becomes impossible. Without our live productions and opportunities to meet, we have all sort of retreated into our corners and relied on the internet, streaming services, and television to keep us entertained. Distant, but entertained. I believe that live theater is a core need of a community and does so much more than just put on shows. It's like nothing else, and that's why it will never go away. It changes people's lives. I'm so happy that the vaccine is out and more people are being vaccinated because that will mean a return to a semblance of normalcy for us. We can plan ahead for our next season, our big annual fundraiser for the building, and begin the tough task of coaxing people out again of their safe spaces, out into the community that we live in, and participating in the culture of our city. In a way, this award is like a vaccination shot for all of us at the Actors Mission as well, a booster shot to get us all back and excited again to bring our town new events and ideas and experiences. I'm not sure that you realize what a wonderful thing it is to be recognized in this way, but on behalf of all of the people who have come in and out of our Actors Mission family over the years, I would like to you to know how much we appreciate to be among the first to receive this award. We are truly honored.
Well, I am so pleased to recognize each of these individuals and wish them continued success in the arts. I would like to thank organizers Chad Banks, Deborah Soule, along with all of the volunteers who helped make this presentation possible. And thank you for joining us tonight. I'd like to close the evening with a word from Michael Lang, the Executive Director of the Wyoming Arts Council.
Hello, my name is Michael Lang, and I am the Executive Director of the Wyoming Arts Council. I would like to congratulate the recipients of the 2021 Rock Springs Mayor's Arts Awards. In the category of Arts Organization, Actors Mission, Arts Patron, Dr. Bernadine Kraft, Arts Educator, Sherry Kumar, and Performing Artist, Stephen Davis. These organizations, artists, advocates, and educators help weave the fabric that make our communities places people want to live, work, and educate our children. Congratulations to all. I would also like to congratulate Rock Springs on its efforts to make arts and culture a strategic pillar of strengthening the community. The arts strengthen the economy, drive social connections, build educational value through both curricular and co-curricular activities, and help build Wyoming's workforce. Critical thinking skills and creativity, both inherent to arts education, are sought after by all employees. Additionally, we know the arts help drive tourism. Local arts events attract out-of-town visitors and bring needed funds to help diversify Wyoming's economy. The arts can also serve as an entry point for civic dialogue, helping drive complicated conversations in our politically divided world. These are just a few of the ways the arts help build stronger communities. The Wyoming Arts Council's board and staff look forward to Rock Springs' continued focus on the arts, and we want to thank you for all you do to make Wyoming stronger.
There are places
for people.